With the Protoss force beaten and scattered, the Overmind has withdrawn the swarms to the remote Ashworld of Chao. Welcome back to StarCraft and welcome to the next Zerg mission. This time we have to, well, once more protect the Chrysalis, which is now a mature Chrysalis. And we also have to murder everyone on this map here, which we will gladly do. Whom we don't have to murder are these Arachnosauruses. They are neutral critters, and much like the Warcraft 2 neutral critters, they don't do anything. Well, even if you do attack them, they don't fight back. So there is a Terran Marine, and there's more of these guys, and we don't want to mess with them. At least not right now. I guess I could send these guys over them. Yeah, these guys here, we've seen them before. They are Mutalisks flyers. They do have, they shoot some sort of parasite, whatever. And those guys jump from target to target, but if they don't come in larger groups, they're quite susceptible to enter. And I have the feeling that these guys here have a couple of upgrades. Oh yeah, they do indeed. So that explains why they are so lethal. So that wasn't so glorious. Oh well, at least we sort of kind of secured these resources here, which is something, I guess. We do have, oh, that's not a Vespian gas guys here. That's like a dead guys here. Oh well, so these guys here will regenerate, so there's that. Also, you guys should definitely harvest. I do have 1, 2, 3, we've got 8 clusters here. So let's get 8 guys to work here, so everyone can work on one cluster at once. I presume that's, maybe it's not the maximum number of guys you need to, so I guess you can have guys working here while the other ones are moving around, but I'm not a professional gamer, so I don't need that level of optimization. So these guys here are going to regenerate. It's going to take a while, but we'll get there eventually. And since we don't have a whole lot of pressure on us right now, we should be good for now. What we also want are a bunch of, well, we probably need overlords soon. Let's get another overlord. Sooner or later we want these anyway, so we might as well get them now. And yeah, you're slowly but surely regenerating. I'm not quite sure whether there's an upgrade that does accelerate that. I don't think that. Oh, look at that. No, no, you're not going to kill my drones. Don't do it. Don't do it. Thank you for dying. And you guys can stay here. You can actually dig these guys here into the ground, but we need to evolve our hatchery for that, which does cost us a lot less resource than I thought it would, but nevertheless more than I care to spend right now. But we're going to get more of these drones, then we're going to get a couple of units to secure this area, even though I think that is actually fairly secure. So let's maybe swoop around here just a little bit to see whether there's planes or whatever. But it doesn't quite look like it, so I guess we can expand here soon. These guys can actually attack air units too, so you don't have to have your Hydralisk there, but we may as well. Let's get more of you. And you're going to help me extract some more Vespian gas here. Oh, well, I guess we are under attack here now, but that's fine. We've got a bunch of guys here, and we can also build some defensive colonies once we are ready. In fact, you can move up here and get me a new hatchery, which, again, is less expensive than I thought it would be. And I guess this is the best position overall. There we go. And we are here on the planet Jar. Jar is your usual ash and lava world. So maybe build a sunken colony here. That's what you would expect from a video game. And this is going to be the new home of the Zerg. Or at least we're going to hatch the Chrysalis here. But the Terran Federation, the Terran Empire, newly founded. Oh, I actually need to. Oh, yeah, well, that's just the. Never mind. So. Alright. Time to get some Vespian gas going. And you can get me even more of these because I want to. Got these crystals, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of these clusters here. And once we have all of that up and running, we are going to build up our army. I don't want to over focus on Nidalisks. They are quite useful, but they are very susceptible to anti-air. So if we don't, what do I want you guys? I think I want you guys to harvest resources here for now. How long do you need? You're almost there, but not quite. Two-thirds done, I suppose. Here we go. And I think I want at least a sun colony here as well, and maybe one spore colony for stealth detection and to deter any air units. At least delay them until I can bring in some reinforcements. Do you want any of this? Possibly, but it's not really a priority right now. We'll get there. We'll get there. You can actually get me an extractor right away. We want that sooner or later anyway. And since we don't need the creep for that, which we do now have anyway, so I guess that's not too important. Oh, what was that? Oh, it's just a critter. So no fear there, but I think I want one of these here. Just as a little precaution. And more of you, please. And since I'm spending half of these guys here on buildings, I don't really need that many overlords, but we'll raise a couple more of those. To. For now, it's just expansion time. And there we go. You can get me more crystals first. And once we have all of that running, and you can get up here as well, you should become, yeah, sunken colony for now. Can't build spore colonies right now anyway, so may as well go with the sunken colony first. Alright. I'm not quite sure what kind of tech the. Do I want? Oh, well, they've got fire bats. That's okay. There's, oh, and but they also have. They've got one or two marines here. There we go. Wish I had siege tanks. Those would make a good addition here. Alas, we don't have them right now. So three more for the Vespian gas case here, and then we can start. Well, then we can build even more of these guys because we want additional. Oh, I guess we're going to do that then. These critters here freak me out. You can actually kill them. You can't attack them directly. But you can force attack them. Then you can take them out. And still want this. I guess I do want this sooner or later. I may as well get it now because I do want. You can harvest here. I do want to have it sooner or later. So, then let's get another one of these here. As well as one anti-air colony here. But one thing at a time. So hatchery. Stay here. And I can. Yeah, you know what? Let's evolve you. Yeah, when you evolve your lair, it's still fully functional, so you don't need to worry about not being able to use it in the meantime. That's quite convenient. There we go. What did I... Oh yeah, I did want you to become a creep colony. That's not really the most convenient placement here, but it's okay. Do I have... Yeah, I've got a decent number of gatherers here as well. Yeah. So this is running quite well overall, and once I have you ready, I can start expanding properly. And you can... Oh, you can actually make me more lava while we're waiting here. Actually, no. But we're trying to make more drones. So, that should keep us moderately safe here. Yep, may as well get that too. And you will become a spawning pool. But and no, you will not, because I already have one. I mean, evolution chamber. Possibly, I will possibly get a second one, because they are fairly cheap, and then we can upgrade a little bit quicker. So I need a spire, which I can afford now that I have my lair here, which you can upgrade later. So test for overlords, overlord side range, fast overlord movement, they're all quite nice, but it's not terribly necessary now. In later missions we probably want this, so you need evolution chamber. Yeah, we'll have one of those soon. You can build me another one of these here, and maybe one more creep colony here. I'll put some anti-air there. And do I want another one of these? Do I want another hatchery? And I could get circle, but you know what? Let's get another hatchery. Because we don't... I mean, it's not that expensive, all things considered. I'll get like one or two units for that. And I may as well get it now. Awesome. Thanks for evolving. So, yeah, we want all of this. What were you supposed to become? We do have the Spire. I think you were to become another evolution chamber. And what's happening here? Doesn't really matter. Well, whoever that was, they are dead now. So, and you become another spore colony. That should keep us reasonably safe. And I can already set your gathering point while we are waiting here, which is also convenient. Also, do I want more overlords? Yeah, let's just get more overlords. Sooner or later we want these anyway. May as well get them, and you will get... Yeah, you will get tentacled. There we go. That's what we want. That's what we want. Hey there. They sense relatively harmless groups right now, because these guys can't harm air units, so... Oh. Can still go after my Hydralisk here, but that's okay. We'll chase these guys here around a little bit. Can you just please hold still for a moment? Thank you. Boom. Come on, just... Boom, there we go. So that wasn't so hard, was it? Can take a step back here. And here we have the Spire. Yep, definitely want the Flyer upgrades. And you can get me the defense upgrade. Where did you come from? It doesn't really matter, because you're dead now. So, I think I want more Hydralisks. They're fairly useful. And they also serve anti-air, which makes them relatively necessary in some cases anyway. Zerglings, maybe I'm not going to rely too much on those. If you fight the AI, you can fight a little bit differently, because there's a couple of units the AI reacts to very poorly, like the Protoss carrier, as well as the battle cruiser. That's a little bit of an issue for the AI, and a couple of other units. And the main difference here is that a human would react differently to those units, so you can't always apply multiplayer strategies to match against the AI. Obviously, if you're really good against humans, you will be good against the campaign AI as well. But the other way around, you may have the edge in a campaign mission in a way that wouldn't give you the edge in one of these missions here. So while we are still building guys and building up and whatnot, I think I want to explore a little bit with my flyers here. They are relatively fast, and we do have the sea of half-cooled lava here. So we can retreat there, and at least land units won't be able to follow us. So there's a bunker, and something tells me that's full of marines. So let's not run into that direction. Yeah, let's maybe not just run into those guys. And instead, let's get an army of hydrolisks to hang around here. Also, how expensive is a mutalisk again? You can also get these scourges here. Not too big a fan of those. You can use them as suicide units later, if I remember correctly. Yeah, let's nevertheless get a bunch of these guys here. And let's explore a little bit with our ground units. Where did you come from? I guess I just didn't pay attention to you, but that's okay. Oh, yeah, that's the kind of guy you want to take out with these fellows here. Hmm. So maybe I should get the overlord transport, and maybe also the speed, but we'll see. So you guys are here now. So I'm gathering more of you. There we go. Got a nice group here. Yeah, you will die now. You can actually retreat since I don't need you here right now. And if I can get more than one tier of upgrades here, I might actually build a second spire here, but we'll see. Guys, just stay here, it's not that hard. Also, may as well get more of you while we're at it. There we go. Almost there, there we go. So we can, can get more of these. In this case, I think I'm going to get another spire just to speed things up a little bit. What did I evolve here in the first place? Oh, yes, we want that. And we also want the second level carapace upgrade, which we cannot afford. But we will be able to afford soon. And where? Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Why did I create three of those? I don't know. But it doesn't really matter. Let's build another one of these. Spires here. What can you guys do? I don't really need you to harvest. Just build another colony here. Let's enter air just because I can. And you, how expensive is the spire anyway? Apparently too expensive to have built another one here. You know what? Just gnaw on some crystals. Whatever. Doesn't really matter that much. Maybe I should be a little bit more patient this time. Are you not? Oh, you were just waiting here. Maybe I should be a little bit more patient this time. And it seems that these overlord upgrades are relatively quick. So, you become the second group here. And I think I'm going to risk getting in here because I can't see any anti-air turrets. And overlord speed, do I want that? I think I do. But I also want the hydrolisk armor. Yeah, let's get that. Let's get the overlord speed. And oh, look at that. Well, you're going to run to these spore colonies and then you're going to die a horrible death. And there we go. And no scratch on you, which is great. So you guys just attack this bunker. Our forces are under attack. And there we go. And then you can take out these guys. There we go. That wasn't so bad. Is the Hive Cluster under attack? It is indeed. Oh dear. No, not the Hive Cluster. Well, I guess that's problem solved itself. But we have to take into account that... Oh, okay, you die. That's okay. Then you will die. And all of you will die, in fact. Oh dear, that's a lot more guys than I thought there would be. Did you really build another one of these while I was just hanging around here? That's not cool. Okay, one group can continuously attack the building and the other group can attack whoever is attacking us here. Okay, stop it, guys. This is another situation where they just send everything they have against us now. I think they do. But it's okay. We'll do some damage here. And even if we fail here, or at least if everybody gets killed, let's put it that way, we should still be able to cause considerable damage and lighten the ranks in their base a little bit. And our mutuals are cooling down, which is not so cool, but that's... I didn't even intend to make that pun. Okay, so let's make... Oh wow, we have... still have two groups, they're just a little bit of a discrepancy in size, but that's fine. And let's just build more of you. Yep, okay, I'll give you more overlords. There we go, and now we can... Yeah, we can upgrade you. And almost there, almost there. Awesome, so then these guys here will be even more useful. So let's take that out without running into the radar, if possible. Because I don't really need more... Don't do that. Don't get in closer. I think these guys always have trouble hovering on the spot. Fine. I'll wait here. I'm also not quite sure... Oh, you just killed one of those guys. I'm not quite sure whether they take more damage when they're clustered. I guess if they get attacked by splash damage, but I'm not quite sure whether that applies to... Okay. Stay here. Which evolution... Oh, so... Okay, so you have the first stage of everything here. That's awesome, I suppose. And let's get more of you. Yeah, I'm going to go full air unit cheese here. Even though it's not really air unit cheese, because while these guys are powerful, it's not like they're invincible. Okay, let's take that out first. And then we're just going to walk in and kill the anti-air turret here and their bunker and whatnot. I'm getting tired of this. There we go. Is that just filled with fire bats? Because I don't really see that firing on me. Or maybe it's just empty. Okay, no more Goliaths, of which I haven't really fought any so far anyway. So I think we're good here. And there we go. More, even more of these guys. Yeah, they're always drifting a little bit, so you can... So it's difficult to just have them stay in one place. And these guys really lack anti-air. The anti-ground is powerful, but I guess there's a reason why they lack anti-air. Okay, everybody kill. And I guess they already sent all their anti-air unit against me anyway when I attacked first, so this shouldn't be too much of an issue. There we go. Then kill their workers. And since we're here, we may as well kill these buildings here. We have to do that sooner or later anyway, so why not now? There we go. And in the meantime, let's get more of these guys. Even more. Awesome. Then take out the bunker, which apparently isn't filled with anything that's anti-air. That's awesome as usual. And maybe kill this guy here, because I don't want them to rebuild anything they have here. Yep, looks like we can wrap this up neatly soon. And also, you know what, let's just stay here. So maybe we can even completely avoid getting into range of those. And what are you doing? No, don't do that. Take this, this and that, so... These guys are now super clustered. I'm not quite sure whether that's dangerous or not. Doesn't really matter at the end of the day. And there we go. Yeah, this mission is, it's probably designed that you have an easy time here with air units, which is fine. I should probably get you guys in here as well. And that should... probably one of their last production facilities, but now since we're here, we may as well take out these turrets, because they are a bit annoying and they're not that hard to take out, so we may as well just go in here and deal with them. And there's another one here. Yeah, there we go. Still, it's probably the best idea to attack from... Oh, and another one. Didn't I have a group 3 here? I guess you are group 3, but I think I messed up the group assignment here. You know what? Doesn't really matter. We've won this anyway. There we go. And the rest is just a mop-up job. They do have a lot of anti-ground here, so those amount of siege tanks they have here, they're a bit scary. That's no problem for us. And you stop chasing units and start chasing these buildings here, please. And you can join in here. There we go. Yeah, looks like we wrapped that up quite nicely. But then again, this would probably... It's not really a tutorial mission, but it still eases you in. Do we have to kill all the units too? Nope, we do not have to kill them all. And there we go. One against Alpha Squadron. And we also won by points, which is very important. Thanks for watching and see you next time.